Hey, what's up everyone? Tim here from Everyday Tactical Vids, and today we're looking at this, which is the brand new Black Scout Survival version 3 tactical flashlight. As you can see, this comes to us from WowTac. They get technical support from ThruNight. Let me share a couple things before we jump into looking at the actual light. In this video, I'm going to unbox it. We'll show you the light. We'll give you the details. And then I'm going to EDC it for a shorter amount of time. And by the end of this video, give you some of those initial thoughts. Then what I'll do in the future is I'll use this for a handful of months, and then I'll come back and let you know what I think about the light. And maybe I'll do that in a pocket dump video, or you know, when I get a new EDC bag, I'll talk about this light as well and my experience with it. So the brain behind this light is Jack from over at Black Scout Survival. I do follow him on YouTube. I watch his stuff. Clearly he knows his stuff. He's got a pretty wide variety of products, I would say, some higher end stuff. This is definitely more on the budget end of things. But let's open up the box, take a look and see what we have inside, and then take it out to the night and use it. So some people are interested in the box, so I'll show it to you. Brown box, WowTac on both ends, nothing on the bottom. On the back, some information about WowTac, and then you have a neutral white version and a cool white version. Looks like this one's the cool white version. I'm pretty sure that's what they meant to check there. So let's open it up and see what comes inside. So you've got some foam, some styrofoam for nice, safe travel. You've got the WowTac information, which we'll look at that in a second. You're going to get the actual flashlight, which comes inside this little plastic bag. It's my initial thought as soon as I saw, you know, the pictures of it, that it's similar to size in like one of the M1X Strikers from Olight or something that size. You've got a switch on the bottom here, and then a selector switch, obviously a pretty aggressive bezel there. So that's what that looks like. Let's move that out of the way. See the other components. You do have a pocket clip there. And then we have the USB for recharging. And then here, what else do we have? I'll get a couple of the filters. And then looks like some O-rings as well. I said a couple of filters. Looks like just one filter there, if I'm seeing correctly. But we'll take this out of the bag in a second and actually put it on the light to test it out. As you can see, I've disassembled it. It does have that little piece of paper that comes in between the battery and the connection point. So make sure you take that out. It also does come with the 18650 battery. 3400 milliamps, and it is rechargeable, and you're going to recharge the battery. So you don't, there's no port on the light to actually recharge it. You're going to be plugging this in, plugging the USB or the micro USB in there and charging this up. So slide the battery in, close this up like so, and we'll show you what it looks like. So there's your, let me click it on and then select through the options here. So high, medium, low. Obviously it's washing out the camera a bit. Let me turn that off and just give you a quick look at the light end to end. You can see the Black Scout Survival logo there, which is very cool. So it looks like end to end. Again, your pressure switch and then your selector switch there. Come back the other way. WowTac BSSV2. You can also see here that this, let me just take this off real quick. So this is the bezel that comes off. You could do it, you could use it with nothing on the bezel, or obviously you can put the filter on. So let me do that now. Pop this out of this bag. And it looks like it's just got threads on it. So it should be easy enough to use. Yep, so I'll throw this on like so. And you're gonna get red light out of this? Yeah. And that's gonna save your night vision, obviously. And then you can still use the selector switch to get, you know, if you want to get less light, more light, whatever it is. It's a very nice dim light there. So yeah, there's a basic look at the light. I definitely, I'm not going to rock the filter. I'll show you that in the darkness in a little bit, but I definitely prefer that more aggressive bezel like that. So there's a look at the light. Some of the details here, with the 18650 battery, you're going to have low, medium, high, and then strobe as well. So your low is 22 lumens. That's going to run for 2.5 days. Medium, 208 lumens for 8 hours. High, 1050 lumens for 2.7 hours. Your strobe is 1150 lumens for 2.7 hours. It's going to be impact resistant to 1 meter, IPX7 rated, so that's for 1 meter. Some of the other details, they have a Cree XP LV6 LED in there. The lens is anti-reflective coated ultra clear toughened glass lens, so it just means it's not going to break super easy. Smooth reflector, let's take a look at that real quick. Inside, so nice smooth reflector, not the orange peel. Inside there. Your material is 6061 aluminum, hard anodized finish. Your dimensions are 139 millimeters by 25.4 millimeters by 24 millimeters, and your weight is 86 grams. So now, let's grab the tape measure, and we'll measure this in inches. So end to end, you're looking at about 5 1/4, and then you're looking at about an inch as far as your width, and then let's, or as far as your diameter, I guess the official terminology. Let's get our little scale out here, turn that on, and we'll weigh this thing. And this is the weight with the battery inside, 4.875 ounces. And now let's take the battery out and we can try it without the battery. And the weight without the battery, 3.14 ounces. So before we take this out into the night and use it, I guess my main thought for people is gonna be, you know, if you want a super compact light, like a stream light, Microstream or something, this is definitely not the light for you. It's just bigger and heftier and it's got more weight. But if you like, you know, a slightly larger EDC flashlight, then this is definitely something you're gonna wanna consider and check out. I haven't put it through the paces. I haven't used it aggressively and, you know, dropped it and put it underwater and such, but the overall construction looks good. And yeah, so I'll be interested to test this out tonight in the darkness and then use it for a while and then let you guys know what I think about it. But enough talk, let's actually see how this thing shines in the darkness. Okay, we're outside now. I'm about 35 feet away from a fence in my yard. I'm gonna put this light on at the highest setting, and just a note that when you press the light, it's gonna come on at that highest setting every time. So this is 1050 lumens. Looking at the fence again, about 30, 35 feet away. So as you can see, if somebody's trying to sneak out, you know, the backyard, I would definitely be able to see them. And shining it here in the middle, I could see all the way over to that end of the fence and all the way over to that end of the fence and beyond. I can see all the way over to that tree there. So once again, there's dark and there's all lit up right there. Now let me scroll through the different settings. We'll go down to 208, which again, you know, at this distance, I can still see from that end of the fence all the way to that end. I can see the tree as well, even just shining like this. And then we'll go down to the 22 lumen option. Let me scroll through again. So 1050, 208, 22. Let me go to the strobe. So strobe warning here. That's what that looks like. Came back at about 55 feet now. We're looking at the same fence here. Let's put it on the high setting. So as you can see, my cars are on both the left and the right side, but say I got out of the car and I heard something, boom, put the light on, and I could see what's going on there. Now we'll go to the other setting options here. So this is the 1050, 208, and 22. You can't really see so great as far as on camera, but I can still see quite well, even at the 22 with this. Let's go back up to the high. And then, yeah, I'm just trying to describe the spill, the flood, or the spill of the light here. So as far as how hot the center of the light is, it's definitely hotter than the spill coming out from it, but it's not, there's not a massive difference. It's not a burning hot center. Down to 22 again, and then let's do strobe one more time. So strobe warning. That's what that looks like. Okay, I've moved to the backyard, and the shed right now in my backyard is about 75 feet away from me. So let's take a look at the different settings one more time. So here's the highest setting, 1050 lumens. Boom, obviously you can see the shed quite easily. I can see, I would say, as far as the backyard, let me show you. So there's one side, there's the other. When I'm shining it at the shed there, I could see probably, I'd say 75% of the backyard quite easily. Drop down to the 208, still quite well illuminated. And the 22, I can see it with the human eye, a little bit hard to pick up on camera. And we'll do strobe one more time here. Strobe warning. And turn that off. Okay, I've gone back out to the front yard. Now I'm looking all the way into the backyard, about 150 feet away. Gonna show you the kids' little playground in the backyard. So at the high setting, so looking through the gate into the backyard, I mean, I am just illuminating that entire area quite well. We'll go to the other settings here just so you can see what those look like. So again, this is the 1050, 208, still pretty good, not nearly as good as the 1050, but still can see. And then down to the lowest setting, 22. Can't really see a ton on camera. I can still see it okay here with the human eye, but definitely that highest setting is certainly by far the best. I mean, you could see this is from almost one end of my driveway all the way into the backyard to the back fence. definitely lights up the whole area. The next test here I want to show you is, imagine you hear something go bump in the night, you grab the flashlight, you turn it on. So I'm at the far end of the first level of our house, so I'm in the kitchen looking back at the door, but check out this light. Boom, I hear some noise, turn on the light, and I mean, that is totally blinding to anybody who's there. Also, you know, just to remind you that you can go straight to strobe by pressing the selector switch. So imagine I just want to turn it right to strobe, hear a noise, turn on the light like this, here comes a strobe. So strobe warning, boom, right to that. Yeah, I mean, that's obviously inside with white walls or light, you know, gray walls, I guess we have here. Very, very bright. Go down to the second setting, around 200, then down to 22. I could certainly walk around the house just fine with this amount of light. It's actually probably too much light for walking around at night, but nonetheless, you can see, definitely gonna give you plenty of light if you have to get up quickly in the night to find out something, you know, find out what's going on. Let's give a quick test here with the red filter on. I'm in my kitchen, looking at the far wall, which is probably about 15 feet away. So here's the red filter that's on at full blast. And then we'll drop it down to 208 and then 22 here. Hard to see. You can see it a little bit on the wall, just to put my hand out here and show you. That's what that looks like. So again, your highest setting, second, and then low. And I guess you could do strobe with this as well. So let's try that, strobe warning. So that's what that looks like. All right, same test looking at the front door now. There's your high with the red filter, your medium, and your low. Back to the high, and here's the strobe again, so a strobe warning. And back to high.
Let's wrap up here talking about the Black Scout Survival version 3 tactical flashlight. I want to remind you that this is a initial impression slash maybe short up to medium amount of time use, and then we'll come back after I've had a chance to use it for, you know, several months, maybe up to half a year, and then I'll let you know what I think about it. If in the meantime you want to see this thing get beat on and used aggressively and stuff, there are other videos out there that that have really aggressively used this. I think of particularly Chris over at Drop Forge Survival. He always beats the tar out of his flashlights when he tests them. So you can head over there, and I'll put links down below so you can go over there if you want to see this used immediately aggressively, and just he just really beat it up, I'm sure. Let's talk about some of the downsides and the upsides of this light. As I mentioned before, size and weight is gonna be an issue for some people with this light. I think about this light and I think EDC light or bag light, emergency light, car light, it fits all those categories. For some people, a light this big is just too big for EDC and or even some of their, you know, everyday carry bags. So that's gonna be something that people have to decide upon. Another thing to think about is just your lumen output. And again, that's a preference thing. Some people are like, you know, I only need 200 lumens of output or maybe 100 lumens of output so they can get something smaller, more compact. Other people are like, no, I want 5,000 lumens of output, so they need something that's different. So that's, again, that's a preference thing. Two other things I want to note about the light. One is the bezel. It can scratch your hand up. So just be aware of that. Be careful of that. When I was reaching into my pocket to grab it one time, or I can't remember exactly what I was doing, but I was using it and I did scuff my hand up pretty good. So be aware of that. And then the other thing is, I found because of the size, like with a pair of khakis, you know, dress pants, something like that, this one's going to just be a little bit too big for me as far as the way it sits in my pocket. With a pair of jeans, or maybe a little bit less dressy pants, I find that this works fine. But I wouldn't be EDCing this if I was, you know, in a suit all the time, just because I feel like it doesn't fit the way I want it to in my pocket. Function-wise, size-wise, just having used it for everyday carry type tasks, this thing works great. I'll tell you a couple things I really like. I do like the bezel. It's aggressive enough that it means business, but if you don't want that, you can just, you know, take it off and go like that. You can put the red filter on as well, obviously. Pocket clip, I'm kind of in the middle on that. If it were a little bit higher, I think that would be good for me. But that being said, I do like that it's easy to get a good purchase on the light when I take it out of a pocket. End pressure switch, if you guys watch my channel, you know I prefer an end pressure switch. And the way it's set up, boom, I can turn it on, boom, I can turn it on. But also, you know, if you get a little bit comfortable with it, you can turn it on and then also, just with your finger, be scrolling through the different settings. So it's nice that I don't feel like one of the things that kind of, I don't know, frustrates, but I'm not a huge fan of with some lights, is end pressure switch and then your selector switch up here. So I feel like I got a fiddle a lot with the light. This one, boom, I can turn it on, and then with my hand right where it lands, boom, I can just start scrolling through just by, you know, squeezing the little selector switch right there. The fact that it comes with a battery, the fact that it's a rechargeable battery, the fact that it's an 18650 battery, I mean, just a lot of wins across the board there. One last thing I want to mention that I do like about the light is that when you turn it on, it comes on at the highest setting. I like that it has a couple different options as far as outputs, but for me, when a light comes on at the lowest setting, I'm almost always going up to like the third or fourth setting. If it has, you know, say 1 to 4, I'm almost always operating at level 3 or 4. So I like the fact that it comes on the highest setting, and then I can go back down to a lower setting as opposed to coming out at the lowest setting every time and having to scroll up to the highest setting. That's a preference thing, so it's got to fit for you. But for me, I like the fact that it's on high, and I can readjust as I need to. I don't want to have to need a really bright light in an emergency situation and have to draw it out and click through a bunch of things to get it to go in that highest setting. Boom, it's on high, and if I don't need that high setting, okay, I can tone it back a little bit. Your price point for this is going to be right around $50 on Amazon, and I've got links down below if you want to head over and pick one of these up. But yeah, I mean, if you're someone who likes, say, a Surefire Fury, Phoenix PD35 or the PD35 TAC, something in that size, then I think this is going to be a light that you definitely want to check out. Again, my initial use having, and I have dropped it and beat it up a little bit, not on purpose necessarily, but having done that, still no issues, and it's working quite well. And yeah, I mean, it's been a cool light. So I want to again reiterate for like the thousandth time, but this is a initial use, you know, a couple weeks I've had this thing and EDC'd it, and then I'll come back in a handful of months at least and let you know what I think about it more long-term use. WowTech through night, as far as companies, I always like to note to people that I have a relationship with them since I review stuff. But that being said, other people who've worked with through night when they've had issues with lights, you know, function issues, warranty issues, generally my experience in talking with those people is that they've had a good experience and haven't had any major challenges that through night or WowTech, whatever in this case, works really well with the average customer out there. So that's just something to keep in mind as well. So there you have it. That's my take so far on the Black Scout Survival version 3 tactical flashlight. Let's hear your comments if you have one of these, or, you know, leave questions. If you have particular questions you want me to answer, I'm glad to do that using the comment section down below. Thanks as always for checking out the videos here on YouTube. Please subscribe to Everyday Tactical Vids here on YouTube if you haven't done so already. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check us out on Instagram and Tumblr as well. More videos coming soon. Take care. Black Scout Survival.